How can you tell if a speaker is bad? Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you some tests for checking the health of your speakers using a multimeter. I have two speakers. Let's see if they are good or bad. This speaker is rated to deliver 5 watts at 4 ohms impedance. Watts refer to the power handling capacity of a speaker. This specification tells you how much electrical power, measured in watts, the speaker can handle without being damaged. Ohms measure the electrical impedance or resistance of the speaker. This tells you how much the speaker resists the electrical current from the amplifier. Most home speakers have an impedance of 4, 6, or 8 ohms. Let's check the resistance of the speaker. Turn the dial to the continuity and resistance setting. Touch the probes to the wires of the speaker. You should see some resistance. There is no resistance. This speaker is bad. To confirm, let's check if there is continuity. Press the function button to toggle to the continuity setting. Touch the probes to the wires of the speaker again. If you hear a beep, there is continuity. I don't hear a beep, so this speaker is definitely bad and should be replaced. Let's check the other speaker. I hear a beep, so this is a good sign. This multimeter can perform continuity and resistance testing at the same time. The reading shows a resistance of around 3.6 ohms. This speaker is good. Typically, a speaker has labels indicating the positive and negative terminals. If it doesn't, you can perform the next test to determine the polarity as well as the functionality of the speaker. If the cables are correctly connected, the diaphragm will move outward. If the cables are reversed, the diaphragm will move inwards. I'm going to perform this test with the help of a 9-volt battery. Connect the black alligator clip to one of the terminals. Connect the red alligator clip to the other terminal. For this test, touch the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the battery and the red alligator clip to the positive terminal of the battery. It may be hard to see the movement of the diaphragm, so let's zoom in closer. Don't touch the terminals for too long since you don't want to damage the speaker. I expected the diaphragm to move outward, but instead, it's moving inward. This means the cables are reversed. Let's reverse the cables. Now we're saying the negative terminal is on the right side and the positive terminal is on the left side. We want to touch the red alligator clip to the left side of the battery and the black alligator clip to the right side. Nice, this is what we expected. The diaphragm is moving outward, so we know the cables are connected properly. This test also verifies that the speaker is functioning correctly. If we reverse the polarity, the diaphragm should move inward. Great, this is what we expected. I hope this video has shown you how to test a speaker with a multimeter. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.